माननीय ऑनरेबल डॉक्टर एल हनुमंतैया जी।
थैंक यू ऑनरेबल डिप्टी चेयरमैन सर। द नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फूड टेक्नोलॉजी एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप एंड मैनेजमेंट बिल 2019, द स्टेटेड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द बिल इज टू कन्फर स्टेटस ऑफ द नेशनल इंपॉर्टेंस टू टू इंस्टीट्यूट्स which are working in the country. One is at Haryana Kundli and the other one is at Thanjavur, Tamil Nadu. Sir, the above institutes are presently administered by the Ministry of Food Processing Industries under the Societies Registration Act 1960. So to provide additional autonomy and flexibility, the bill aims to provide functional autonomy to these two institutes to design and develop courses, undertake research and achieve enhanced status in their academic pursuits to emerge as pioneers at the global level. Sir, these new institutes will be the non-profit legal entities, number one. Number two, implement reservation policy as per Central Education Institutions Act 2006. And the bill establishes Board of Governors, Senate for each institution, Central Council to oversee the performance of the institute, and the council headed by the Food Processing Industries Minister. Sir, the Government of India will finance every year, determined by the Government of India, and it will be passed by the Parliament, and the accounts are audited by the CAG. It is a good step which was taken now. Sir, this NIFTM 2019 bill, India is a major producer of agriculture and food items in the world, third largest producer of agriculture products, which includes pulses, milk, tea, spices. First is China, second is USA. The food production depends on agro-climatic conditions of any country. India needs developed, skilled, technical manpower for achieving the real targets. So the Government of India targets 3% international food trade as against 1.5% now. So only 10% of the food is processed in India now. Sir, opportunities are great. Demand for processed food in India and abroad is increasing now and the future days also. Sir, the NIFTM 2019 bill introduced in Rajya Sabha on 13-1-2019 by the then Minister Srimati Harsimrat Kaur Badal and referred to Standing Committee on 22-2019. Sir, the Standing Committee elaborately discussed with stakeholders and lot of new things have been introduced in the bill. So introduction of the bill, the lower the wastage of food in the country, which is a serious concern. Sir, according to UN's Food and Agriculture Organization study, about 40% of the food is either wasted or lost in the country, which is a very serious concern. Second, it is valued about $14 billion. The waste food in the country is about $14 billion. It is one of the estimates. So India ranks 94 of 107 countries. Every third child is malnourished in the country, which is also a serious concern. Sir, one side we are wasting about 40% food, the other side the deprived children are in a big number who are malnourished in the country, which is a very serious concern to us. Sir, there is a demand in this industry to create alternative employment. Sir, the study says there is a demand for 1 lakh as against 10,000 skilled people available in the country. See, 1% growth in the food processing industry will generate 5 lakh direct employment and 15 lakh indirect employment. This is the study again. So there is a great demand for skilled professionals for food collection, food processing, cold chain management, etc. So strengthen the domestic supply chain is the concern of the day, which is in high level demand. So food processing industry has got a big challenge and a big scope also. Sir, corporate data analysis says food processing firms are profitable, but the value addition component needs to increase significantly in the country. Sir, India had made vast progress over the time providing food security for its people, though it is a big number, about 130 crore, by bringing Food Security Act, and we are growing the food products in the whole world. We are number one in many areas. Sir, food processing industry is one area which has the potential to add value addition to farm products. Sir, about 11.2% of total arable land, 11.2% total arable land in the world is ranked in our country as number one in production of milk, pulses, and jute. Sir, we are number two in fruits and vegetables. We are number three in cereals, but as per the Government of India 2019 study. So India is sixth largest food and grocery market in the world. So as per available data of 17-18, we are having a large scope of food processing industry in the country. Sir, as per the 17-18 study, food processing industry accounted for 7.9% as against 9.5% in agriculture if agriculture value is added. So a major employment provider is agriculture, which is 11.4% of the organizational manufacturing employment. Sir, food processing in the world and India comparably is a shocking news also. Sir, there are countries, particularly China, their food processing capacity is 30%. Western countries, it is 60 to 80% food processing is being done. And particularly in USA, 65% of the fruits and vegetables are processed. So overall processing of the agriculture produce in many countries are 70%, 23% in China, 30% in Thailand, 78% in Brazil, 80% in Malaysia, etc. But we in India, we are fruits and vegetables, we are processing only 2.2%, sir. This, I think we have to take note of this. And we are biggest processed milk products, milk and milk products, it is about 35% in the country. And 21% for meat we are processing, and 6% in poultry products. This is the status of Indian food processing system. Sir, food processing in India is in the nascent stage. Less than 10% of the total food in India is processed as per 2016 government study. So we have to take it up very seriously. Food processing in India has lot of scope and we have to take it up. Sir, less than 10% of the processed in India and traded. So in India, we have to gear up by inverting necessary infrastructure, which is very, very important. Requires steady flow of raw materials from the farmers, meeting specific quality standards at stable prices. So ensuring steady flow of income to farmers can reduce wastage, particularly in perishable items. Sir, The institute should be encouraged to build bridge with industry, with farmers, farmer producer organizations and cooperatives. This is the most required thing to develop these institutes. Sir, income generation potential of the food processing should be a priority. Why I am telling you? So that the primary producers can retain the larger share of value at the farm gate and village level. So the standing committee, which the bill was referred, has given very valuable suggestion after elaborate discussion with the stakeholders. Sir, they have noted the Institute of Technology Act of 1961 recommends 3 members of parliament to be in the governing council, which is not there. Sir, I also demand the parliament members should be in this governing council. There are a lot of farmers who are working with farm products and agricultural area. They can contribute more to this system.
आपका समय समाप्त
सर सर I'll come back.
One minute.
In 2 minutes I'll finish. Yes. Because of this connecting, farmers can contribute a lot, particularly MPs. I demand the government to include at least 2 to 3 MPs into the governing council of this. So the NIFTM of Thanjavur and Kundli are not providing fee waiver. This is one of the recommendations of the standing committee. As per the AICT Act, fee waiver must be given so that you can encourage a lot of bright people into this. So they can be trained and their employment opportunity will be a big opportunity into that. So that is one of the demand of mine, to get very good skilled person. We need to encourage fee waiver into this. And on the other hand, the Thanjavur Institute has recommended for fee waiver long back, but that institute has not implemented it. So I again demand the institute should waive the fee and encourage the rural students to come into the system.
Thank you.
And also, sir, last only 1 second, sir, I will take. And reservation implementation of SC, ST, OBCs should be implemented properly into these institutes, which has been recommended by the standing committee.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Shri Dr. Ashok Vajpayee ji.